As a content creator, a business owner, and someone who uses Canva all the time, I know how disorganized Canva can get if you don't set it up with the right organization system. And so in today's video, what I want to do is walk you through my simple system for keeping Canva organized so that I can find everything when I'm looking for it. So if that's you and you can resonate with that struggle too, definitely keep on watching. Hi, my name is Kayla and I help content creators create better content for better results. So be sure to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell to get my latest uploads every week. All right, so in today's video, we are going to be talking about how to get organized and stay organized on your Canva account. So here's what we're going to cover in today's video. Whether you are new to Canva or have an existing Canva account, I'm going to help you get organized from start to finish. We're going to set up your brand kit, set up your folders inside of Canva so that you're organized. I'm going to let you know behind the scenes of what I would do, whether I had a free Canva account or a pro account. I would also going to show you how to link your external storage like Google Drive, OneDrive, whatever external storages you might have, how to actually link and connect it to Canva and start designing, editing, sharing, using your mobile device to help you stay organized. The first thing you're going to want to do is get yourself a free Canva account. You might already have a free account, but you can sign up really easily connecting your Google account, your Facebook, or your email. I happen to have a pro account, but I'm going to show you all of these features using a free account. And if your free account or your pro account looks something like mine, where you have a mishmash of different Canva templates, it can be overwhelming because you might want to find something. And if you've been using Canva for as long as I have, it can be difficult to find things. So the first thing I want you to realize is that anything you put in the search bar in Canva is going to look through the text on the actual design. So if I want to look for this template down here, how to plan for the fourth quarter in your business, I don't actually need to know the title of that document. I can search for text in that document. As you're going through this tutorial and organizing your Canva and your account and your templates, remember that you can come back to that search bar. So for instance, if I type in fourth and I hit search, it's gonna show me all the Canva templates, but then I can click on your designs and it's gonna show me all my designs with the text fourth. So it's a great way to search for documents without actually knowing the title, because you might not have started organizing your Canva account yet. So that's just a great tip to start. As we get started setting up and organizing your Canva template, the first thing that you're gonna wanna do is set up your brand kit. You can find your brand kit on the left sidebar of your Canva account. And in your brand kit, there are some pro features, but we'll talk about those in a second. What you'll want to do is make sure that you add your unique brand colors, at least three of them, because any more would be an upgraded feature. But as long as you're putting in your brand colors, you're going to find that the designing process is going to happen much faster and in a way more organized fashion, because you aren't having to enter in your hex code or your colors every time you use a new template or a design. So go ahead and set up your brand colors that you want to use regularly. Now, as mentioned, there are pro features of adding your brand logo or your brand fonts. These are going to level up your experience on Canva and make designing much faster. So you won't have to go search for your logos or search for your brand fonts. They can easily be applied to every template within one click. And I'll show you that in a future tutorial. But basically, adding that feature of adding your brand logos and your fonts will make the design process much faster. From there, we want to move on to step two, which is setting up your folders. Now, with a free account, you get the ability to create two folders on Canva. So if you have a free account instead of a pro account, you should have two essential folders. And I'm going to tell you what those are. The first folder is going to be your brand elements. So these would be like your headshots, your logos. So go to folders and go to create new folder, and you'll want to name that folder brand elements and hit create. This is where you're going to add all of your logos, your headshots, and any other elements that you use within your branding regularly. So as you can see, I've added in a black version and a white version of my logo, and I've added in a headshot. Now I can easily access these items anytime I'm in a design. The next type of folder that I recommend for anyone who has a Canva free account is going to be a templates folder. So this will be a separate folder strictly for your templates that you use over and over again. So go ahead and hit create and type in templates or my templates, however you want to label it. But this is where you're going to keep the templates that you use regularly. So if you want to add something to these folders, you can come over to the upload button and upload something from your files, or you can come over to your designs and hover over a design. Maybe it's your Instagram templates, or maybe it's your Pinterest pins, and you'll hover over the three dots and you'll come to move folder, and you'll go ahead and move it to my templates. But the thing that's going to keep you really organized is labeling these templates as template for that platform or that use, so that you know what it is every time you go to use it. So if this is not a good name for your template, like I have right now, I'm going to rename it to Pinterest Pin Template. That way I know exactly what it is and what I want to use it for, and the word template within the title is going to remind me that this is the master template and not something that I should change or redesign unless I want to actually change the template. Now, if I were in a Canva Pro account, I would add another folder for content slash marketing. So this would be a folder where I would organize my working documents. So if I wanted to go to that template and create a set of Pinterest pins for, let's say, January, I would come to that template and I would make a copy of it, or I would open it. And instead of making the change to that design, what I would do is I would come to File, Make a Copy. I would name that document January. So here I've named it or labeled it January Pinterest Pins, and I would go to File and Save to Folder, and I would add it to my third folder, which would be content slash marketing. That way I could organize the work that I'm currently working on. Now, if that's not something that you can do because you're using a Canva free account, then I would go ahead and save it in my templates. Or I would just remember that these labels are searchable. So I would make it's searchable, and then anytime I want to find a working document, I can just come over to my search bar or go to all your designs and discover and find the things that I'm currently working on. Next is a really important step, especially if you utilize photos or elements outside of Canva and you don't want to upload them one by one. You can actually link any external drives by coming to More and going to the Google Drive extension and connecting your Google Drive account. Once you have everything connected, you've got your folders organized, you're ready to start designing from desktop, which might be something that you're already very familiar with. But if you're not very familiar with Canva, then your next step is going to be designing with a template. Templates are a great way to get started with using Canva, and you can find templates up in the top left corner and actually search for templates or look for their recommended
templates that you can use.
And if you're part of our Ivory Mix community, search through our Ivory Mix templates to get your hands on Instagram templates, Pinterest templates, and more. It really creates a cohesive environment for your social media and your social presence and takes the guesswork out of searching for Canva templates. With a free Canva account, you can easily upload your elements or your media, whether that's images, videos, or audio, right through the design canvas. But you can also discover other elements and things inside of Canva. But the one thing that really helps you get organized is saving elements and items within Canva that you want to use regularly. And that's by using the starred feature. So if you find something in the elements that you like, you can click the three dots on that element and hit star, and it's going to save that element in the stars tab so that you can access these things regularly. So it's just like uploading your own documents, but organizing it in its own folder within the design process. Another way to stay organized within Canva is to apply the same filters and effects to photos. So if you have a photo that you want to add or apply a filter to, and you want to apply that filter across multiple photos, you can go to Edit Image, go to the Adjustments, and click on See All, make any adjustments that you want, and then come down to the bottom to Filter Code. You can copy that filter code and come to any photo, hit Edit Image, See All, and paste in that filter code. Now, it works the same if you wanted to, in the same design, click on Copy Style and then click on another image. But let's say you want to create a new design and you haven't applied that filter yet. That's where the filter code comes in handy. So anytime you want to apply that filter code to any future design, you just need to copy that. And you can save that code in a document or on your clipboard or some place where you can easily access it so that you can apply it to any future photos in any future design going forward. One of the next best ways to stay organized on Canva is by using the Canva app. You can actually create new designs right on your phone when you have an idea. It keeps you connected with the tools that you use in your business, but also allows you to share any design by clicking the download button and heading up to any of the social platforms and sharing directly from Canva into social media. But you don't have to use your phone to share to social media. You can actually do it from your desktop too. You just come to the three buttons at the top, and under the share title, you can find all kinds of platforms and social media that you can share your designs to right from Canva. So you don't even have to download the documents. You can just share, which really simplifies your process and helps you work smarter and not harder when you're using Canva. As far as organization goes and staying organized on your Canva, one of the best things you can do is get a Canva Pro account, because you do get a lot of added features like resizing. You can resize any design into another size. So if you want to share an Instagram post on Pinterest, but you want to resize it to Pinterest, you just come to resize and type in Pinterest, and you'll be able to click and resize it to Pinterest. But more than just resizing, you can actually schedule your posts. Scheduling is a great way to stay organized with Canva because it keeps your content schedule and your content creation all on the same platform. So you just come up to the three dots and click, and when you want to schedule something, you come to the platform and you can connect the platform. Once it's connected, you're able to schedule it. I have Canva connected to Pinterest. So if I wanted to schedule this Pinterest pin, I go ahead and click on schedule, and pick a date in the future. And so I'm going to go ahead and pick the 21st, click done, click schedule. It's preparing to schedule my design in Pinterest. It's scheduling all of the images, but you could just schedule one. But when it comes to organization on Canva, this is where it really shines. You can go to the content planner, and right from the content planner, you're able to see all of your content that's scheduled in an organized way right from the content planner. Now that you've learned everything you can in this video and are ready to move on to the next step, I've gone ahead and put together this free resource for you, and you can grab it right below this video. If you like this video, go ahead and let me know by giving it a like or adding your favorite part of the video in the comments below. And if you decide to save or share it, go ahead and tag me so that I see it, and you'll get a chance to be featured on my Instagram stories every week.